Some hip hop, bing bong, hip hop, boing bong. This one, we're gonna hit up that man, JUICEWRLD. He died, I believe. All I know is, in the past like 2 or 3 years, I just keep hearing rappers are getting shot or something. Like these young ones, I've never heard of. These, and then JUICEWRLD is one of them. I don't know if he's the one who died in Florida. I'm not making fun of him or nothing. I'm just saying, like, I'm curious, right? So, what I'm getting out of this so far, come and go. It sounds kind of depressing. It just honestly sounds kind of depressing. I don't know if you name a song "Come and Go." It sounds like some sort of experiences in life. So, if I'm remembering correctly, my friend told me this album was released after he died. So he's kind of pulling the Tupac card right there. So let's see. "Come and Go" by JUICEWRLD. I'm a metalhead, so just remember that. Whoa.
Try to be everything that I can, but sometimes I come out as being nothing. I try to be everything that I can, but sometimes I come out as being nothing. I pray to God that he make me a better man. Maybe one day I'ma stand for something. I'm thanking God that he made you part of the plan. I guess I ain't go through all that hell for nothing. I'm always fucking up and wrecking shit. It seems like I perfected it. I offer you my love, I hope you take it like some medicine. Tell me ain't nobody better than me. I think that there's better than me. Hope you see the better in me. Always end up better in me. I don't wanna ruin this one. This type of love don't always come and go. I don't wanna ruin this one. This type of love don't always come and go. I don't wanna ruin this one.
That was Juice WRLD. Come and Go. That wasn't awful at all. That I would say this reminds me a lot of some emo kid shit. While I was listening to lyrics, and I can plainly tell you that's some emo kid lyrics from like 2000. Like this is some new wave emo without the band. He even has some guitar in there for the chorus, and it's the cheesiest fucking thing. This is the type of song that's on top where people say, oh yeah, look, hip hop's using guitars and stuff, and all he really did was one fucking chord and go. And that's all it really takes to make something sound catchy to begin with. And just remember that part, because that's a cheesy way to get people to get into something really catchy. I do appreciate that they did that, though, because I haven't heard that really. It's kind of an old thing to do with actual claps, unless this is just something like EDM-wise, because I didn't realize Marshmallow was part of this, too. So, it's kind of funny how it's developed. I'm like, I could definitely see this. It's like some white girl little, like, I mean, I hate to say it like that. It's like little, yee, skippy lyrics in the chorus. I'm just like, this is so cheesy. I definitely could say, like, he's good. Like, he's definitely interesting. He keeps it fun. But I don't really think that was that good. That was probably the cheesiest, most sketchiest, cheesiest thing. The cheesiest of cheese that you can do in, like, music. He added all the elements, which was perfect. So, and the lyrics, you know, they probably relate to a lot of people in their emotional young teen lives. Judging by the album cover, I'm assuming that most of the songs are about himself. Usually people that have an album with their face on it, it's all about them. If you haven't realized that, people that have albums with their face on it, it's all about them. It's just all about them. Whatever's in their mind, it's all about the pride they have in themselves, their experiences. You're going to personify it to make it relatable. The lyrics are always going to sound relatable because that's how you sell yourself. So on the most part, I'd give this a 9. It's actually really good. I absolutely hate it, but it's good. Like, I could say it's good. His voice, he could have actually been a good singer. And because, honestly, I don't know when everyone's going to get tired of this. I'm just going to talk and rap like this, and it's going to be real good because I'm going to use autotune. And that's just, it's really mundane. Come from an outside perspective, as someone who listens to primarily metal, yeah, I'm giving it a 9. It's got catchy elements. It adds in a lot more than any other hip hop song, which this wasn't really like hip hop. This is more like emo, EDM, R&B rock. I don't know what the fuck it is. It's a mix, but you know, like I said, I don't know if he's actually dead. I think he's dead. I mean, either way, yeah, good for him. I mean, good job. I meant for the song. Good for him. Yeah, I don't really have any much to say. Come from an outside perspective again. I hate that songs like this will be glorified in the sense that it has so many things going on, like how I'm talking about. But it's really not that many things going on when you really just know how music works in production. And it's one of those songs you sit there and think, like, how the fuck is this selling on top of the list when there's people with so many, like, greater talents out there that know what they're doing and can do so many different things. But, you know, that's just a subjective view on me. You're free to disagree with me. Thanks for watching. That was Juice WRLD, Come and Go. Thank you.